You're a busy guy, but they're offering you a lot of reality shows. Is that true?
I get offered every single reality show. Dance with the Stars.
Oh, you got offered that?
Dance with the Stars. Urkel? Is Urkel really a star now? I think they should call it Dancing with Ex-Celebrities Who Didn't Save Their Money. That's okay. What they should name it. Have you seen Celebrity Ghost Stories?
No, I haven't seen
Celebrity Ghost Stories, where celebrities go on and they talk about that they've seen ghosts.
Yeah.
Like 100 celebrities have seen ghosts. They also happen to pay you $6,000. Now, they offered it to me. If I would have seen a ghost, I guess I would have done it. But the thing that gets me, these celebrities that have seen the ghosts don't seem to be working that much. You know what I mean? George Clooney doesn't see ghosts. Brad Pitt doesn't see ghosts. Meryl Streep, Andy Dick saw a ghost. Corey Feldman saw a ghost. Jermaine Jackson saw a ghost. So I'm just wondering if the money has anything to do with it. Maybe I'm cynical, Carter.
They see ghosts every week.
You know what I'm saying?
I saw another one.
You know, it's quite a bit. How come there's not like 100 bus drivers saw ghosts?
No, it's only celebrities. All right, now, you are hosting a show about real-life hitmen.
Real-life hitmen.
This is a fascinating concept, because we're all fascinated by the whole concept of a hitman. Hitman, what kind of stories are you hearing? What are some of the good stories?
We have a story coming out. There's a woman. A man and a woman are married for 17 years. They're getting divorced. He doesn't want to give up, and I'm telling you the truth, he doesn't want to give up his baseball card collection in the divorce. So he hires a hitman to kill his wife. She's 5'6", 260. She's a nurse. The hitman's 5'8", 180. He's in the house waiting for her. Hits her in the head with a hammer 3 times. They fight for a half an hour. She's on camera telling you this, and she's choking him. She turns the tables. She says to him, "Who sent you?" And his last words are, "Boy, you're strong." I hand to God. She lives to tell the story.